Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. Welcome to a feature release video. Great news, Elementor 3.18 has been released and there is some cool stuff which is happening right now in Elementor. And in this video, we will show you what are the latest features. Some of the cool features are Element Manager, where you can manage all of the elements to display on your Elementor screen. You can also check the element usage if these elements are being used on any of the page, which will improve the performance of your WordPress website. So make sure to watch this video completely because it will benefit you a lot if you are using Elementor to build your website. And without further ado, let's continue to the screen recording of the Elementor new features released in Elementor 3.18 beta. Before we do that, make sure to comment on the video below. Let us know what more you would like to learn and subscribe to our channel. Okay, let's go.
Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. I'm your co-host Nidashik with another tutorial on Elementor. Today, I'm very excited to share with you guys that Elementor has introduced the 3.18 beta version. So all you need to do is update to this version and it is ready to use. Okay, so I'll tell you step by step what updates this version has. First of all, we have the hide widget updates. Okay, so what you need to do is you need to go to Elementor here. Here, this is something new, Element Manager. Let's click Element Manager first. Okay guys, so one of the highlights this new 3.18 beta has brought for us is the ability to adjust your widget panel with the new Element Manager. It helps to empower you to choose what widgets are enabled in the editor, resulting in the performance boost to your editor loading. Okay, now let's see how it works. What we have here is the widgets which we are using. Okay, so we can choose Elementor widgets, WordPress widgets here, and Elementor Pro. Okay, let's choose all plugins. If I need to deactivate this widget, for example, I need to deactivate the accordion widget, what I need to do is I need to deactivate it, click save changes, save here, and I've inserted a page here. So let's search for an accordion widget here, and you can see that the widget is not available to use anymore. So this is working properly. What else we have here is the scan element usage. Okay, so this will help us to tell you the times which you have used this widget. Okay, and the time those widgets which are not used. So what you can do is you need to click this deactivate unused element here so that you can simply deactivate the widgets which you're not using, and it will help to reduce the load time. Okay, so the next update which we have in this 3.18 beta version is the multi-select for the taxonomy filter. Okay guys, now you guys can see that I've already added a loop grid here. I'll show you guys the loop grid. Let's click preview here and see how I've added the loop grid. Okay, second, third, okay. Okay, so this is the loop grid. What I'll do is here I'll drag taxonomy filter here just above this, like this. Okay, you can see select a widget here and you need to choose a loop grid to view the taxonomy filter. Okay, select a taxonomy. All I have done is categorize my all the movies here so that it's easy for us to add a taxonomy filter. So I've given all these movies some categories like comedy, crime, horror, mystery, thriller, and those which are uncategorized are here. Okay, so if I click comedy, only the movies with the comedy will appear here. Crime, okay, like this. Let's select all for now. Okay, now I'll tell you what this updated version has. We have another loop item which is the multiple selection. If I click this on, you get two options, logical combination here. They will give you a combination of and or. Okay guys, so now you guys can see that right now we have selected the and logical combination. Okay, let's click update here and let's preview how we can use it. Okay, so if I want a crime and a mystery movie, okay, let's unselect it, crime and a thriller. So this is the one which is both a crime and a thriller. Okay, let's select all now. If I want horror movie, okay, and a mystery. Okay, so we have these three here. So this is how this and combination looks like. Okay, so if I want or, let's click update here. Let's preview. Okay, either the movie should be on crime based or a thriller. Okay, let's unselect thriller. Okay, if I want a crime based or a horror, so we get all the movies which are either on crime based or a horror one. So we have these four here. Okay, so this is working very nicely, properly. You can categorize your movies or anything you want your post, and you can use this multiple selection widget. I hope you like this second update here. Okay, so the third update which this 3.18 beta has is the nothing found message. What I did is I just opened the navigator. I choose the loop grid here. In content additional option, you can see this nothing found message. If I switched it to on, you can either choose this message, it seems we can't find what you're looking for, or you can type on your own. Let's stay with the message which Elementor is showing us. Now what I'll do is I'll select the taxonomy filter here, go to settings, and in multiple select I'll choose and click update here. Let's get this loaded as well. Okay, so if I want comedy and a crime movie, so if it won't be available, what we get is the message. It seems we can't find what you're looking for. So this looks super easy and organized. So this is the third thing which 3.18 beta has for us. Okay, next update which we have is attachment in forms here. So what I'll do is I'll search for a form widget and drag it like this. I'll choose the add item option here, scroll down. Okay, let's scroll down here. In type you can choose file upload. Of course, previously files were stored on your site server, which could impact your site's available hosting space. Starting from this version 3.18 beta, you will have the option to set the form's behavior so that the uploaded files are sent to you in the form of email inbox with the help of this email with attachment. This will store the file in your inbox instead of the website server. To do this, you need to go to the form builder and click on the file upload option. Here you can choose the file and just fill it and send it, and it will go with the email with attachment. So this is the latest update which 3.18 beta has brought for us. Other than this, we have the performance improvement in 3.18 beta, the accessibility improvement, and much more. So if you like my tutorial, don't forget to subscribe my channel, hit the like button, and comment below